Ma dyn ma, sy'n mysio dwi'n mac sy'n fain, ac sy'n croetio'r hwnnw yn y nis Elan Lois. Am dyn ni'n gwaith rwtbog mewn mi'n hun, ac croetio'r hwch yn ho. Fym dyn nhw hwyl cael am yn galic, ach zon yn ydyn nis, ha mi rhi mach a unio, sy'n ti jac am subtitles chyfyd hwyl cael. So I'm going to switch to English and tell you a wee bit about crofting here. You can see here, fence there. So crofts here are strip crofts, about 25 metres wide and about a mile long. So that way we get the full spectrum of soil, the macher in there towards the shore, then the further inland you go, the more peaty and less fertile the ground is. So it's all livestock that I have. My dad plants some potatoes, that's about it. If it's not, doesn't have legs and moves around, I don't really have much interest in it. So obviously you can see cattle behind me just now. I'm quite new to cattle. About 4 or 5 years ago, I just decided on a whim to buy some Highlanders. There's two of them there. They spend pretty much all their life out on the common grazing. They're in just now for calving end of next week. And they've been brilliant. I wish I got cattle years and years and years ago, because they've been so easy to handle when they stay in the fences that they're supposed to. But they've been brilliant. And even though I've only had them 5 years, I think I'm starting to see some improvement on the land as well. You know, the rougher stuff, the stuff that was a bit rank, starting to improve using crofts that have been sitting unused for years, even though the commission might not admit to that happening. Getting some other crofts back into action using them. My main activity is the sheep. I think most crofters here have had sheep, and sheep have always been part of my life here. I've tried to insulate myself from the market by finishing as many lambs as possible and selling them as meat boxes. So hopefully this year, maybe 20 to 50 lambs going as meat boxes. We'll see how that goes. I think COVID could help a little bit, and that people have maybe opened their eyes earlier this year and became more aware of food chains and making sure that they're stocked up. So hopefully that'll work in my favour and in anybody else that's doing meat boxes. I've got pigs as well. Unfortunately, Ronald De Boer, my boar, has been firing blanks this year. So it looks like no pork boxes this year. They've been really popular because nobody else in Lewis and Harris has pigs. So there's always really good demand for pork. And this year I'm doing my first beef box, and it's going to be this guy. He has always been a little bit aggressive, and it's been quite, you know, not a difficult decision, or I know it's going to be a little bit difficult, but this week he has started interacting with me a bit more, and I know I shouldn't have done it. It's a rookie mistake, but it is what it is. My main source of income is from eggs, so I've got a big hen house up there and then a couple of smaller ones down here. They're on two different agricultural holdings with double fencing in between. So that kind of gets around some of the rules in regards to egg hen numbers. If you have more than 350 on an agricultural holding, you go up to the top tier of regulations. So somebody with 400 hens has the same regulations as somebody who has 4 million hens. Doesn't make sense to me, but you know, that's how I get around it anyway, by having the two crofts next to each other. I've got... This is an owner-occupied croft that I own. That's my mother's croft there, and that's another croft that I'm the tenant of. So lucky to have these three next to each other. This year I built two polycrubs. If you're not aware of them, they're a Shetland designed, similar to a polytunnel. These black pipes are recycled from fish farms, and they are robust. They will withstand 120 mile an hour winds, so should be okay here. This is my livestock one. So I've got my shearing set up there. I've finished shearing. I've just got about 10 to do. That's this one. The other one is a feed store and, you know, just a general agricultural building, and it's storing a lot of cheap wool just now that, it's an issue for everybody. But that takes me to some of my other byproducts. So wool is one of them. I've got Hebridean sheep, I've got Shetland sheep, and then your normal commercial sheep. So the Hebrideans and the Shetlands, I've been working with used wool the last few years and making my own knitting yarn out of that. Doesn't make huge money, it's expensive up front, but it makes more money than sending them off to the wool board. So it doesn't work for everybody, because you've got to be able to reach customers, and I'm fortunate that I can. The other thing is that I do lamb meat boxes, and one of the byproducts I had from that was the skins. So again, for quite a few years now, I've been sending skins to Skye, to the tannery there, and I get these skins back. Again, these are expensive as well, but more than happy with the profit I make of them, and I probably double my money on each lamb, and there is less waste from each lamb as well. So quite happy with that. A little bit of tourism too. People come and visit, and I mean, I'm living the dream. I've had people pay me to muck out my hen house. If you can do that, you can do anything. Just a final word on the Young Crofter of the Year Award, which I was fortunate enough to win in 2018. It can be a thankless task being a crofter. I think, you're not doing it for thanks anyway, but you don't get any if you're in a small crofty community. People do try and keep each other grounded. You don't stick your head above the parapet, all that kind of stuff. So it was a real confidence booster, a much needed confidence booster. That I was nominated, that I was a finalist, and that I managed to win it. So really happy about that, and I would encourage anybody else to enter as well, because even thinking about it, you can confirm to yourself as well what you've done, the advances that you've made, and also if you're a finalist or if you win it, you get a lot of free advertising out of it, and that always helps.